Starting with invocation, let us chant from verses 11 to 20. Kayena manasa buddhya केवलैरिन्द्रियैरपि योगिनः कर्म कुर्वन्ति सङ्गं त्यक्त्वात्मशुद्धये युक्तः कर्मफलं त्यक्त्वा शान्तिमाप्नोति नैष्ठिकीम् अयुक्तः कामकारेण फले सक्तो निबध्यते सर्वकर्माणि मनसा संन्यस्यास्ते सुखं वशी नवद्वारे पुरे देहि नैव कुर्वन्न कारयन् न कर्तृत्वं न कर्माणि लोकस्य सृजति प्रभुः न कर्मफलसंयोगं स्वभावस्तु प्रवर्तते नादत्ते कस्यचित् पापं न चैव सुकृतं विभुः अज्ञानेनावृतं ज्ञानम् तेन मुह्यन्ति जन्तवः ज्ञानेन तु तदज्ञानं येषां नाशितनात्मनः तेषामादित्यवज्ञानं प्रकाशयति तत्परम् तद्बुद्धयस्तदात्मानः तन्निष्ठास्तत्परायणाः गच्छन्त्यपुनरावृत्तिं ज्ञाननिर्धूतकल्मषाः विद्याविनयसम्पन्ने ब्राह्मणे गविहस्तिनि शुनिश्चैव श्वपाके च पण्डिता समदर्शिनः इहैव तैर्जितः सर्गः येषां साम्ये स्थितं मनः निर्दोषं हि समं ब्रह्म तस्माद् ब्रह्मणि स्ते स्थिताः न प्रहृष्येत् प्रियं प्राप्य नोद्विजेत् प्राप्य चाप्रियं स्थिरबुद्धिरसम्मूढः ब्रह्मविद्ब्रह्मणि स्थितः Hariom, you have to unmute yourself.
Yeah, okay. Verse number 13, where we were studying. this concept in verse number 13 keeps repeating throughout the Gita and all of a very oft-quoted the verse, the concept. The concept is manasa sanyasya, mentally renouncing all actions. Throughout, from right number chapter 2, he keeps repeating it. Manasa sanyasya, mentally renouncing all actions. Mentally renouncing all actions and self-controlled. This idea keeps coming up again and again and again. So, renunciation of actions mentally and having self-control. The embodied rests happily in the city of nine gates, neither even acting nor causing to act. The idea of practical Vedanta. According to Krishna, this is practical Vedanta, which we may not understand, which we may not agree with. According to Krishna, the practical Vedanta is action and not mentally attached to the action. There is an action and there is no mental attachment to action. Combining these two is the challenge. Combining these two is always the challenge, the difficulty. Because how can you do and yet renounce mentally? For doing is always for us a mental bondage. All our doing arises out of a mental bondage. Here is a doing arising out of what is opposite of mental bondage. See, doing can happen in two ways. Doing can happen out of a mental attachment or bondage. Doing can happen as an obligation, duty. Mentally renouncing means he does what he ought to do as obligations. So the first thing that is very important is the general way of doing always happens because of a attachment. Attachment either to the doing or attachment to the result that you are going to get out of it. Either you are attached to the doing or attached to the result that you are going to get out of it. Now, mentally renouncing means manasa sanyasya, means there is neither attachment to the doing nor interested in the results of the doing, and yet doing happens because it ought to be done. The moment you ask, the moment you hear this statement, it ought to be done, the question that you will ask is, what is the natural question? Natural question that you will ask is, why? Why? Oh, because I am a recipient, I have to do. Karma Yogi has that attitude. Sannyasi says, as long as you are alive, you have to be in action, and there is no other reason to act other than the fact that you are being alive. The fact that you are being alive, you have to be in action. There is no other reason for action, which is very difficult for a layperson to accept. That is why in the initial stages to bring in the obligation, we say, we talk about gratitude, we talk about Rana, you are a recipient, stop taking, at least start giving and all that. having evolved, what are we discussing here? Describes the state of supreme being. Describing the state of supreme being. When he is describing the state of supreme being, mentally renouncing all actions and self-controlled. What is mentally renouncing all actions? No attachment to the doing, nor interested in the results of the doing. Then what is driving his actions? Then what is driving his actions? He will turn back and say, This is what I ought to do, I am doing. Will you ask a rose, why are you giving fragrance? Will you ask the sun, why are you giving light? Similarly, why do you have to ask me, why are you acting? Are you able to follow? Will you ask the rose, why are you giving fragrance? Will you ask the sun, why are you giving light? Why do you have to ask yourself, why do you have to ask a human being only, why are you doing? The why implies a purpose, a motive. When you ask why, what are you asking? The purpose, the motive, a result. The state of supreme being way of acting is manasa sanyasya, mentally renouncing. It is obvious that mental renunciation happens only through knowledge and understanding. Mental renunciation happens only through knowledge and understanding. He is not asking any one of you to do this. He is saying the state of supreme being is this. Carefully follow. He is not asking you to practice immediately. You ask, how do I do it? He's not asking you to do it. If you ask, what should I do? The answer is, if you ask, what should I do? What is the answer? Shravana Manana Karma Yoga. At any point of time you ask, what should I do? The answer is Shravana Manana Karma Yoga. That doesn't change. Here he is describing the state of Jnani, the supreme being. What is that supreme being? Mentally renouncing all actions and self-controlled. I'll come to self-control later. First is, what is this mentally renouncing action? What is this mentally renouncing action means? Urvarukamiva bandhanat. We have seen it any number of times. Urvarukamiva bandhanat. You are in it and not. You are doing and yet you are not doing. You are doing and yet not doing. Action done because that is the swabhava, it keeps happening. As long as the fuel is there, actions will happen. Mentally renouncing action means there is no adding up current to fuel. Whatever the existing fuel is, actions are done, the fuel is exhausted, it's over. What is attachment to action means? Attachment to action means the way in which you act, you keep adding more fuel. The way in which the Ajnani acts, he keeps adding more and more fuel. Why more and more fuel? Because we want to punarjanma so much, no? We want to come back again and again and again. We can't just leave this. We want to come back. We have such an attachment to this that we want to come back again and again and again. We are not willing to. We cannot consider let go. We can consider making it better. Understand the difference. We are all willing to make it. We are all willing to make it better. Even here, we come to Vedanta class with the hope that our life will become better with the knowledge. We will be better equipped to handle things. We will make it better, better, better. Sannyasa as such is impossible to accept, to digest. It means that much of knowledge has to be gained. It means that much of knowledge has to be gained. Here is a person who is practicing action. He is acting because there is fuel. As long as fuel is there, action will happen. As long as fuel is there, you forcefully stop you from acting, you will be called a hypocrite. Mithyacharasya uchyate. So as long as fuel is there, action has to happen. But you have to act, but then you act in such a way that you add up to the existing fuel. So manasa sanyasya means acting and ensuring that no further fuel is added. No further fuel is added. This no further fuel is added. No further fuel should be added, must be added, comes from knowledge. Comes from knowledge. Manasa, anyasya, and then he talks about self-control. Actually speaking, the word self-control has no relevance here because he has no value for it. By default, he has, just as you have perfect self-control over toys. You have perfect self-control over, self-controlled over toys. For no toy will tempt you. No toy will disturb you. No toy will tempt you. Addition of toy will not bring about excitement. Reduction of toy will not bring about a depression. Why? Because you have understood it as toy. So again, self-control. Self-control is not that you are tempted and you are withdrawing, practicing self-control. It is a natural state of evolution. The beautiful example, the closest example that he gives is the toys. He has got perfect self-control in relation to the toys. And what he does, Navadvare Pure Dehi, embodied rest happily in the city of nine gates. That is very simple. That is very simple. Nine gates is the physical body. Nine gates is a symbolic of the physical body. What he means is, he is like any one of us residing in the city of nine gates. We are also residing in the same city. He is also residing in the same city. It's not that he is in a different city. Yeah, he is also residing in the same city. They are also residing in the same city. But there is a fundamental difference between the way that we reside and the way that he resides. What is the fundamental difference? Like in the Mundaka Upanishad, he says, Dvasuparna Sayuja Sakaya, the two birds. One bird is sitting depressed, another bird is singing merrily. One bird, both of them are birds, both of them have wings to fly, but one bird has known that it has wings to fly, another bird doesn't know that it has wings to fly. It has forgotten that it has wings. Therefore, one bird sitting in depression, another bird sitting happily whistling in the same tree. Therefore, mentally renouncing all actions and self-control, the embodied rests happily in the city of nine gates, neither acting nor causing to act. Neither he does action, nor he delegates others to others. He neither acts nor tell others to act. Na eva kurvanna nakarayan. Beautiful word. In all the traditional commentaries, this verse is quoted very often. A very famous oft-quoted verse in all the traditional commentaries. You see the commentaries of the Shankaracharya, and you see all his other Prakarana Granthas and all that. This verse will be quoted again and again and again. Quite a lot of times this verse is quoted so much. Why? Because it's like so much is packed in one verse. Na eva kurvanna na nakarayan. Look at that. Neither acting nor causing to act. Neither acting nor causing to act means what? He neither does nor propel others to act. But sir, Krishna is prompting Arjuna to act, no? Krishna laughs and says, where am I prompting him to act? He wants to be a hypocrite. I am telling him, don't be a hypocrite. His vasanas are there already. Arjuna, are you able to follow? The argument will be, but Krishna is telling Arjuna to act. The Shastras are telling us to do karma yoga again and again and again. So when they are, so how can you say that it doesn't cause to act? It says, it doesn't cause to act, neither it acts. How does it work? It neither causes to act, nor does it act, in the sense that it understands the driving force for action is vasana. The driving force for action is vasana. So he need not tell you act. Shastras is not the one telling us to act. Our own vasanas are there, which will drive us to action anyway. All that they say is, direct your actions in such a way that you exhaust the existing fuel and don't add more fuel. You act in such a way that your vasanas should exhaust. You don't act in such a way that your vasanas multiply. See, adding fuel means vasanas multiply. So you do not act in a way where your vasanas multiply. You act in such a way where your vasanas reduces. And the formula for vasana reduction is karma yoga and all that. I'm not getting into that. A person having done that has reached a state. What? The residual vasanas are there. As long as the residual vasanas are there, action will happen. And for all practical purposes, the jnani says, I have switched off. Because of the residual vasanas, action keeps happening, which you will not know it from outside. This can never be known from outside, means a third person can never know it. Only that person, third person or second person, nobody can know it except except that one. You can never know it from outside. Only that person knows it. We all act in such a way that we add a fuel to our, we add fuel. What is adding fuel means? Bringing in a worldly motive for action. When you bring in a worldly motive for action, you increase your fuel. That worldly motive can be making the world better. That worldly motive can be helping others, making the world better, all that. But still there is a motive which is worldly by nature, and that is what is known as adding fuel. What is wrong in helping others, sir? There's nothing wrong. You should help others. Vedanta also says help others. But what will happen out of helping others? You will gather a lot of punya, and that punya will help you to take the particular body. Maybe you will take the body of a deva, god, and enjoy the merits of it and come back. Enjoy the merits of it and come back. Person say, "Yuvlonala life nalla poyinirundhu sir. Life was going smooth and well and everything na punya nartham. The punyas, you are living a life of punya. Punya is supporting you. Punya is supporting you. And suddenly one day, one thing will happen, and whole life takes a U-turn, irreversible turn after that. And the fellow says, What happened? Nothing has happened. Your punya has got exhausted. You came back from heaven. Where is the difference? The other way of acting is what? You understand through knowledge, you act, you gather vasana, you act, you gather vasana, you act, you gather vasana. The cycle is a meaningless, futile cycle. Punarapi jananam, punarapi maranam, punarapi janani, jatare shayanam. Punarapi maranam, punarapi jananam, punarapi maranam, punarapi janani, jatare shayanam. He keeps saying it again and again and again. A person having understood the limitation of this, the futility of it, the uselessness of this, takes to a different path. Continuing the path, you become a sannyasi, and then you become a jnani. So yogi, sannyasi, jnani, the gradations. The yogi, the sannyasi, and jnani. Na kurvan na karayan. These two are very, very important to understand. I am a very influential person, sir. I influenced others too. I am a motivational speaker, person say. Vedanta says, you are adding karmas to you and you are adding karmas to another. I motivate people to invest. I motivate people to become an, I don't know what all we want to motivate others. But one thing we will not motivate is, one thing you cannot motivate is, what is the one thing that you cannot motivate? Sannyasi. That you cannot. Because the very word itself is so scary. The very word itself is so frightening. Yeah, causing others to act is also part of the same vasana. Why? Because I still have value to the result. The see, why do I want to motivate the other? See, when I see a motivational speaker also has a purpose for his motivational talk. No, he wants to influence others also. What is the purpose? What is his motive to influence others? For what? Material well-being. Avladana. At the end of it, material well-being. Can you ever say, let us all turn into a? Can you ever say, let us all turn into a sannyasi? First of all, you will get scared. First of all, you will get scared to say this. Not only you will get scared to say this, the others will. The others will run away from you, throw you out. Who is? What is knowledge? Are you able to follow? What is? Na kurvan na nakarayan. Nakarayan means, yeah, the person takes pride in that. Adthangla pambra madri suthi vekkanum sir. Yeah. And that person is a very good manager. Eh? In your office, please do this, sir. In your office, you have to do this. If you don't do this in your office, you will be sent home. Abram, don't come to me. And don't become a competitor to me. Yeah. And they will send you out, and then don't become a competitor to me and say, I will also start a class, and don't become my competitor. In a space, yeah? There is no space here. No. Ingella entrepreneurship la kedaiyadhu, sole proprietorship da inga. Others will not be. Yeah, angala entrepreneurial spirit la kedaiyadhu. Nobody will be allowed. So na kurvan na karayan, beautiful is these two words. Na kurvan na nakarayan, he neither acts without involving in action directly or indirectly. That's what it means. He doesn't involve himself in action directly nor indirectly. That's what it means. Even though I was just putting it in a very light way, what it means is you neither get involved in action directly nor indirectly. That is why you always say, how do you ensure that you don't get involved in actions indirectly? You tell the other, it is your choice. You are responsible for what you are. You are responsible, and the consequences is yours. Na kurvan na karayan. Beautiful. How did Krishna establish that na karayan? Yata ishyasi tata kuru. In the 18th chapter, he said, Do as per your understanding. Na kurvan na karayan. Are you able to follow? Nakurvan na nakarayan, meaning it is explained to you. Now the choice is yours. The responsibility is yours. When we say the choice is yours, the responsibility is yours means the consequences are yours. You can't come back and say, Manohar. You can't come back and say, neenga sonnele sir, I did. You said so, sir, I did. Now what happened? You can't ask that. You can't ask that question. Yeah, adella self protection. Disclaimer. Self protection. Disclaimer. Nakurvan, such a noble state, such a very high elevated understanding. That's what you need to. What an elevated understanding. He is the responsibility, the consequences is yours. Are you able to follow? Why it is said in this manner? Because we have seen this any number of times. Freedom begins with responsibility. Everyone follow? See, the fellow who doesn't want to take responsibility, like yesterday, the fellow who doesn't want to take responsibility, what can that person do? Freedom begins with responsibility. Throwing away freedom is throwing away responsibility is throwing away freedom. Are you able to follow? Freedom and responsibility are two sides to the same coin. People want to be free but not take any responsibility. Clear? I will do any work, sir, but don't give me that responsibility. Engitta kuduthradinga responsibility you take, but I will do everything. Are you able to follow? Freedom begins with responsibility. You want moksha, you have to take responsibility. Responsibility, what is responsibility? Means responsibility means you accept that you are the cause for your, you are the architect of your fortune, you are the architect of your misfortune. You make yourself, you mark yourself. This is taking responsibility, and the person who can take this responsibility becomes free. In a general case, we always blame. Are you able to connect? In the normal case, the blaming is always done to an external factor. What is the external factor blaming? Sir, I was happy and peaceful. That fellow came and made a remark that agitated me. So as long as that person doesn't make the remark, I am peaceful. Therefore, who is the cause for my mental disturbance? Who is the cause for my mental disturbance? For the last 36 hours, I am looking at the US election. 264-213. Maricha Tharla this morning. I don't know whether it changed this morning or not. My God, till late last night, for 36 hours, 48 hours, 264, 213. So agitating. At least, young Mark, at least add up 264.5, 213 point, or 212 something. No, nothing is so. It is very clear that the external factors causes. It is very, very clear that external factors causes mental agitation. What happened? Change aayta? Ellar mandayattral kaalangaarthal endha onne read times na read eternities not times na all read times and come and sit in the class. That's why I am giving old news, you are giving latest news. Arthala endha onne you are supposed to read eternities not times. If one person has said I also don't know, sir, I would have felt very happy. Everybody is nodding their heads. Okay, correct. What else to do? Na kurvan na karayan. There is neither involve in action directly or indirectly. Why? Because he understands. Why he doesn't get involved in action directly or indirectly? Actions are born of identifying with action is nothing but identifying with ignorance. For actions are born of ignorance. Good action, bad action. Actions, Vedanta never said bad actions are born of ignorance. Actions are born of ignorance means good as well as bad. Good as well as bad. Therefore, identifying with action means identifying with ignorance. Affinity with action means affinity with ignorance. Here, we are talking about getting back to your original nature. That we have seen is not a product of action, because the true nature is not a product of action, because it is already there. You are that. They don't say you are going to become that. That's why that Mahavakya itself is so beautiful. It is not said you are going to become that. It is said tat tvam asi. You are that already. You are going to become that means future, product of action. Yeah, future, product of action. You are that already is not a product of action. Very, very interesting, very beautiful verse. Verse number 30. And we move on to verse number. Yeah, before we move on, yes. The question that she is asking is, when we say mentally renounce all actions, does it mean you have to renounce obligatory actions also? At the level of karma yogi, don't renounce. If you are at the level of karma yogi, don't renounce obligatory actions. That is where in the 18th chapter, he tells, which we have seen already. In the 18th chapter, he says, Arjuna, renounce all actions, but do not renounce yajna dana tapas. 18th chapter, he said, renounce all actions, but do not renounce yajna dana tapas. Why? Because you are at the level of the karma yogi, and you need to do. You, if you say renounce yajna dana tapas, then how you will exhaust the existing vasana? Are you able to follow? Therefore, at the level of the karma yogi, you have to renounce. Or you have to renounce what? Kamya karma, you have to renounce. Desire-ridden actions, you renounce, but do not renounce yajna dana tapas. Once you reach the level of the sannyasi at the higher stage, you say, there is no renouncing obligations there. Why? Because you have already fulfilled your obligations, you have already done your obligations, therefore there is no renouncing obligations. At jnani level, at the level of jnani, he is acting like any one of us, but mentally completely detached. A sannyasi is making an effort to get. Yogi is trying to become a sannyasi. A sannyasi is trying to become a jnani. A jnani? What is a jnani? He is not trying to become like anybody because he has recognized himself. Are you able to follow? Therefore, mentally renouncing all actions means, please understand, in relation to a jnani, because it is written in the English language, it has to be written like that. All this has to be understood in past tense. When it comes to a jnani, it has to be understood in past tense. Past tense means mentally renounced all actions, practiced self-control. But then the way in which it has to be done in English language, it looks like he is doing everything in the present. When it comes to a jnani, are you able to follow? When it comes to a jnani, you have to understand everything in jnani. Purthuring ellam past tense da, are you able to follow? Still we say him because, still we say all this. Why? Because navadware. Why we still have to talk about all this? Because of navadware pure dehi. Navadware pure dehi means he is like any one of us residing in the city of nine gates. Are you able to follow now? Because he is also residing like any one of us in the city of nine gates, we talk, we have to use these words, but there is a fundamental difference. Are you able to follow? Who? What is jnani doing? What is the man of realization doing? Simply exhausting his, simply doing what he ought to do. If you are a butcher, if you are a butcher, do butchering. That's where the jnani does simply what he ought to do. That's where one of the Upanishadic rishis, we have seen, one of the Rigvedic rishis is a, one of the Rigvedic rishis is a butcher. Very difficult for us to accept how a butcher can be a, because for us jnani means social worker, compassionate, loving. These are all our understanding of a jnani. A true jnani is completely defies our understanding. A true jnani is too difficult to digest. We can digest a smiling, loving jnani. We can't digest, and yet one of the Upanishads, the guru is a butcher, the Brahmin boy, the seeker. Brahmin boy means seeker. Whoever is a seeker turns into a Brahmin. Brahmani jarati idi Brahmana. So a Brahmana goes to the town asking for this master. They say, where is this man? Where is this man? Nobody in the town knew that he is a great master. The Brahmin boy asked, where is this man? They said, outside the village, there is a butcher shop. Go there. You will find that man. So he went and asked that man, I have come to meet this person. Where is he? He says, wait. He says, wait. Seeker can wait. Seeker means one who can wait. Patience. We all can't wait because we are not. We are also wait. Now we get very angry. Yeah, we get very angry. 2 minutes we can't manage. Yeah. A person came to Buddha and said, "I want to know the answer." He asked a question. Buddha said, "Wait. How long?" 1 year, wait, 1 year. 1 year wait, na, he can't go back and come after 1 year. Huh? He has to sit in front. He said, why do I have to wait for 1 year? Another person sitting pulled his shirt and said, we four are sitting, can you see? Yes, go back. Queue up to get the answer. Go and join the queue. He looked at them and said, when did you all come? He said, I came 4 years back. This fellow said, 3 years back, 2 years back, you go and join the queue. Wait. We can't wait. The Brahmin boy waited. He said, wait. He waited. And he saw this man the whole day. What is he doing? What is he doing? Cutting, skinning, selling. Cutting, skinning, selling. Every time he cut, he uttered the prayer and he took the best part of the flesh and kept it aside. That's what he was doing the whole day. Evening time, sundown, he washed the knife, he cleaned the place, the best was distributed to the birds, the animals, everything. And then he came in front of him and said, what is your question? The Brahmin boy instantly prostrated to him. The Upanishad said, now that you have prostrated to me, you have known it. Go back. Education is over, huh? The boy, he said, wait. He waited the whole day. He saw what he was doing. And when he said, ask the question, the boy prostrated. The guru said, now that you have prostrated to me, you have understood. Go back. Huh? Are you able to follow? What does the jnani do? If you are a carpenter, do carpentry. If you are a plumber, do plumbing. If you are an electrician, do electrician. If you are a vettina, be vetti. It doesn't matter. Yeah, be vetti. Huh? Which is impossible for us to even accept it as a possibility. It is impossible for us to even accept it as a possibility, because in our way of action, we always have a value for the action, and the action must give a materialistic benefit. You do an action and that action must give a benefit, fruit, result. Are you able to follow? So what does the jnani do? The jnani doesn't do. That's why the jnani says, I am not doing anything. But you are butchering. That is my swabhava. That is my nature. What does the rose do? You ask the rose. Rose says nothing. I am not doing anything. But you are giving fragrance. That is my. He calls that as Swabhava. He calls it as Swadharma. Are you able to follow? He would call it as Swabhava Swadharma. Verse number 13 to 19, we are discussing. What is the topic? The state of the Supreme Being. Are you able to follow? When we are discussing the state of the Supreme Being, so many looks may look impractical. So many things may look illogical. So many things may be very difficult. But the state of Supreme Being is that. Are you able to follow? Sariya? This is verse number 13. Again, I repeat the sequence. Sir, karma yogi nalo, you say renouncing the fruit of the action. Sannyasi also, you say renouncing the fruit of action. Jnani also, you say the same thing. Then what is the difference? The sequence is this. A karma yogi is detached from the fruit of the action while doing the action. While doing the action, do not be bothered about the the fruit. Are you able to follow? While doing the action, do not be bothered about the fruit. Means he still has a desire for the fruit. He still has a desire for the fruit. And the way that he wants to acquire the fruit is by a legitimate means. But he still has a desire for the fruit. That's where he tries to be dharmic. He tries to be, he tries to acquire in a righteous way, blah, blah stuff. Are you able to follow? I'm not getting into those details. So a karma yogi is one who is interested in the fruit, but renouncing the attachment to the fruit of the action while doing the action. Are you able to follow? Because of the alternative practice that he is doing. What is alternative practice? Apart from renouncing the fruit of action while doing, what is the alternative practice? The alternative practice of Shravana Manana keeps explaining to him the futility of. Are you able to follow? So, because of this combination of these two, he matures into a sannyasi. What is a sannyasi? Are you able to follow now? Sannyasi says, my interest is in. My interest is in who am I? That's all his interest is. He is not interested in. But what is the benefit of knowing who am I? What is the benefit? At least go back and help the world. At least go and benefit the world. For who am I? What is the benefit? Only you will get the benefit. How selfish it is. Correct? Huh? Sannyasi says, I have no time for all this. Answers. Go back and do Shravana Manana, you will get the. Are you able to follow? Go back and do Shravana Manana, you will get the answers. Who is a Jnani? Who is a Jnani? Jnani says, if I am a butcher, I'll be butchering. You can't go and ask him, have you fulfilled your obligations? You can't ask a Jnani that question. Why? Why you can't ask Jnani that question? He will turn back and ask, in which dream are you talking? In which dream? For the entire phenomena is like a, the entire phenomena is the dream. So have you fulfilled your obligations in the dream? The Jnani says, I have. What does the Jnani say? Have you fulfilled your obligations in the dream? The Jnani says, I have. What does the Jnani say? I have woken up. I have woken up. I am awakened. I am awakened. Abdinna, what happened to the dream? Who will ask this question? Who will ask this question? Are you able to follow? You say, I am awakened. Another waker, will he be asking what happened to the dream? Another waker will not ask what happened to the dream, correct? Another waker will say, what does another waker will say? Nothing. Correct? Huh? Who will talk about the dream, the obligations of the dream, that you have left people behind in the dream? Who will talk about all that? Dreamer. Therefore, as long as you believe that you are the dreamer, you have obligations. the moment you have recognized that you are the moment you have become the waker, everything winds up. Everything winds up. So you can't ask, what does the jnani do? Nakurvan. That's why he is saying very clearly, I am a jnani, nakurvan nakarayan. Neither do I do anything, nor causing to act. And this not causing to act is very beautiful to understand. The enlivener is not the cause for action. He is not enlivening an action. You can ask that, which I already described in the last session. You can't ask, is not enlivening an action? Enlivening is not an action because it never had a beginning. It will never. Action means it has a beginning and an end. Action means it will have a pala. Then only it can be called as an action. For something to be called as an action, it has to have a beginning and an end, and it should give you a pala, and that pala must be diminishing in nature. Then only it can be called as an action. Enlivening, when does it start? When it will end? What is the reason for enlivening? Is there any motive for enlivening? No. Is there a fruit for enlivening? No. Therefore, enlivening is not an action. Therefore, he says, Nakarayan, I am just the enlivener. I don't cause. Are you able to follow? Very, very subtly it is. So elevating, so liberating is this knowledge. Nakurvanna Nakarayan. Neither acting nor causing to act. Sariya, verse number. Sannyasi is not an enlightened person. We have seen it any number of times. Yogi and sannyasi are not enlightened people. It means they are still in the dream world only. Where is the confusion? Yogi and sannyasi are called yoga, trying to unite. They are not yet united. Itself, it is implied. It is so obvious. Are you able to follow? They are trying to wake up. In amongst those who are trying to wake up, one has just started the journey, another has reached advanced state. Where is the difficulty? Of those who are trying to wake up, one has just started the journey, other has reached an advanced state. So obviously there will be differences. What A does, B will not do. What A and B does, C will not do. It's simple. It's straightforward. So beautifully he is explaining. These things are all very, very simple and straightforward. Are you able to follow? Is it clear now? At every stage, you take yogi itself is enlightened. You take sannyasi itself is enlightened. You take jnani itself is enlightened. Now you will have a problem. Yogi is. That's why I spent two sessions in the first class. Yogi, sannyasi, jnani gradations. Yogi, sannyasi, jnani gradations. Yogi is the one who is a yogi, who is also working for enlightenment, but he has just, who is a yogi? Yogi is one who is working for enlightenment, started the journey. Sannyasi is one who is working for enlightenment in a advanced stage. This is told very, very clearly. This is explained very clearly. The difficulty is you all come and sit for class fresh every time. Every class mo fresh ah undu ukkaradunala da it become our detachment to the knowledge is so complete that it is unbelievable detachment to the knowledge. Yogi is one who is working for enlightenment. A sannyasi is one who is working for enlightenment. Yogi has started the journey. Sannyasi is in a advanced stage. It means obviously there will be differences. What A does, B will not do. What A and B does, C will be completely different. Are you able to follow? Yogi, sannyasi, and jnani. The sequence. Verse number 14. Venkat. நீ ஒரு வருஷம் எப்படியாவது முடிச்சிடணும் இருக்கா. Verse number 14. ந கர்த்ருத்வம் ந கர்மாணி லோகஸ்ய ஸ்ருஜதி பிரபுஹு ந கர்ம பல சம்யோகம் ஸ்வபாவஸ்து ப்ரவர்த்ததே. ந கர்த்ருத்வம் ந கர்மாணி லோகஸ்ய ஸ்ருஜதி பிரபுஹு ந கர்ம பல சம்யோகம் ஸ்வபாவஸ்து ப்ரவர்த்ததே. Meaning, the Lord creates neither doership nor actions nor the union with fruit of action for the world, but nature manifests itself. Swabhavastu pravartate. The Lord here refers to Atman, Brahman, Jnani. For all are one and the same. Are you able to follow? Lord means Atman, Brahman, Jnani, all are one and the same. Na kartrutvam, na karmani, na karma pala samyogam. Na, na, na. In Sanskrit, na means not. Na kartrutvam, na karmani, na karma pala samyogam, lokasya srijati prabhu. The prabhu, the Lord, the jnani, creates neither kartrutvam, doership, nor actions, nor the union with the fruit of the action. Nor the union with fruit of action for the world. Svabhavaha pravartate tu. Tu means but. See, these are all very simple words that you should remember in Sanskrit. Na means not. Tu means but. Tasmat means therefore, because these three are used right through Bhagavad Gita. Na means not, tu means but, tasmat means therefore. These three at least you should remember. You don't have to become Sanskrit student. You need not know Sanskrit language, but these three words you remember. But swabhavastu pravartate, nature manifests itself. Nature manifest itself. Swabhava. Swabhavastu pravartate is a very, very beautiful indication that nature manifest. Pravartate implies that which manifest exist destroys. Pravartate means the three factors. What are the three factors? Creation, maintenance, destruction. So whenever they talk about the word pravartate, what is implied in that? Creation, maintenance, destruction is implied. Seriya? Creation, maintenance, destruction keeps happening. For that is the swabhava. Creation, maintenance, destruction keeps happening. For it is the swabhava. It is the swabhava. Creation, maintenance, destruction is the swabhava. Swabhava of what? Swabhava of prakriti. Swabhava of prakriti. You can call swabhava of what? Matter. The prabhu. Who is prabhu now? The Lord, the Atman, the Brahman, the Jnani, who is the prabhu, has nothing to do with any of this. It means, are you able to follow? It means what? God is neither the creator, God is neither the maintainer, God is neither the destroyer. All our notions of God gets. But our tragedy is, we will nod to this verse and we will nod to that also. Yeah. We will agree to this and we will agree that God is the creator, maintainer, destroyer. We are a unique category of people. Either we have to say, that is right, this is wrong. Or we will say, this is right, that is wrong. But we are a unique category where we will say yes to both. In the category, I don't know who has to come and save us. Are you able to follow? God is neither a creator nor the maintainer nor destroyer. That Brahma Vishnu Maheshwara is what, sir? Krishna is saying Brahma Vishnu Maheshwara is Brahma Vishnu Maheshwara is prakriti, nature. Brahma Vishnu Maheshwara is prakriti, nature. They are not gods. For what is God? What is Brahman? What is Jnani? Na kartrutvam, na karmani, na karma pala samyogam. Karma pala samyogam. He is refuting all wrong notions of God. That's all. See, people say one notion of God. Karma pala data, they say. God gives. God will ensure that you will get the. God will ensure that you will get what you. God will make sure that you will get it. Na karma pala samyogam. So that school is that idea about God is negated. Na karma pala samyogam. Look at the words. So direct he is. Na karma pala samyogam means he doesn't create union with the fruits of the action. He doesn't create. He doesn't cause it. Neither he creates, neither na kartrutvam, na no kartrutvam, no karmas, na karma pala samyogam. Are you able to follow? Karma phala samyogam means God kadavula paathu kuduthathu sir idu na karma phala samyogam. God doesn't, it is difficult for us to digest this God, huh? It is difficult for us to accept this God. Why? Because we come with our own conditionings about what God is. Na karma phala samyogam. God doesn't create the union. For the union happens by, the union happens because of the prakriti. That is why the beautiful off-quoted easiest example about God and action is, what is an example we have seen any number of times? Petrol and car. Where did it come from? Na karmani na kartrutvam na karmani na karma phala samyogam. Correct, sir. Krishna is saying this, but still, we should worship God, no? Answer is, do worship God and go back to Shravana, and do worship God, continue worshiping God and go back to Shravana and Manan. Are you able to follow? Beautiful three words. Na kartrutvam, na karmani, na karma phala samyogam swabhavastu pravartate. Swabhavastu pravartate means nature manifest itself. The nature continuously goes through the cycle of creation, maintenance, destruction. Creation, maintenance, destruction. Creation, maintenance and destruction. That this is the swabhava of, the swabhava of nature is what? Creation, maintenance, destruction. At the microcosmic level, at the macrocosmic level. At the microcosmic level, it is birth, growth, disease, decay, death. At the macrocosmic level, it is pralaya. But nevertheless, the same happens in microcosmic level and macrocosmic level. What is it? What is it that keeps happening continuously? Creation, maintenance, destruction. Creation, maintenance, destruction. And all three are interrelated. Creator irundha da maintainer ku vela. Maintainer or velai olunga panna da destroyer can do his job. And the moment destroyer does, creator will come and has to start. Are you able to follow the cycle? Creation, maintenance, destruction. Creation, this is the nature of swabhava, and the Prabhu, the Lord, has nothing to do with this. Why? The Prabhu, the Lord, is Sakshi, witnessing enlivener. The Prabhu is Sakshi Chaitanya. We have seen that. Witnessing and witnesser and enlivener. Witnesser and enlivener. Witnesser and enlivener means in its presence everything happens. It doesn't do anything. The swabhava of nature is creation, maintenance, destruction. Prabhu is Sakshi, the witnesser. Prabhu means Lord, Atman, Brahman, Jnani, all are one and the same. They are the witnesser and not and witnesser enlivener. another important verse. In its presence, everything happens. It remains a sakshi to the multifold activities, but doesn't get involved in anything. The Prabhu. Another important verse, another beautiful verse that is talking about the state of the Supreme Self. We'll continue with verse number 14 next. Before that, I conclude. There is, let me see, there are clarifications. Vijayarangal, 290, 214. Read not, at least Kalangarathal, and the only read not. Read not times, read eternities. After that, you read the times also. Huh? Hindu, anything, whatever. I don't know, whatever you, whatever it is. Bharat, did I clarify? Just type. Chandralekha, are you there, ma? Yes, sir,
I'm there.
Yeah.
இது வந்து புரியறது புரியாமலும் இருக்கு, ட்ரீமர் மாதிரியும் இருக்கு, வேக்கர் மாதிரியும் இருக்கு, ரெண்டுக்கு நடுவுல ஒரு ஸ்டேஜ்ல இருக்கு.
கரெக்ட். கர்மயோகி,
பிகாஸ் கர்மயோகிக்கும் அவ வேலையை செய்யறான் பட் வித் வித் அவர் ரெனவுன்சிங் தி ஃப்ரூட். ஞானி பட் அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் தி கிரேடேஷன்.
Yes.
Particularly for Jnani, is very yes. difficult.
Yes.
Because he also is doing action according
correct.
To you.
Yes, exactly correct. Yeah. Right. It is difficult to understand that gradation because a Karma Yogi is renouncing the fruit of action while acting. Sannyasi has the complete knowledge of action as a result of which he is transcending the very action itself. A jnani becomes the enlivener of action, the gradations. Idhila yogi and sannyasi in the order of growth can be understood. The shift from sannyasi to jnani is a huge jump which is very confusing and complicated because it is like from the dream you become the awaker because the jump is from finite to infinite. The finite to infinite jump is always impossible to comprehend because any number of finite additions will not give you the answer as infinite. Is it okay, ma? Yeah. Bharat. Question of Bharat. Renunciation relates to the fruit of action.
Can Bharat you... left.
Yeah, sorry?
Bharat left.
Bharat left. Okay. I will talk to him later because it is this one. Rajshekhar. People say there is one more gate in the top of the head. எங்க இருக்குது ஒன் மோர் கேட்டு? நைன் கேட்ஸ் தான், டென்த் கேட்லாம் கிடையாது. There is no 10th gate. Rajshekharan is asking, I know where he is coming from. They say there is one gate here. கேட் எல்லாம் இல்ல, there is no gate here. It is a imaginary thing. It's an imaginary. இங்க இருக்கிறது வந்து there is a gate here they say. And the logic they give for that is, I know the logic also they give because I have heard that, I have tried all that. No, so I know all that. They say, for half a liter of oil you take and you rub. In 10 minutes, half a liter of oil gets ஃப்ரிக்ஷன்ல எவாப்ரேட் ஆயிடுறது அவ்வளவுதான் இட் இஸ் நாட் கோயிங் த ஹாஃப் லிட்டர் ஆஃப் ஆயில் இஸ் நாட் கோயிங் இன்சைட் த ஹேர் பட் வாட் இட் மீன்ஸ் இஸ் சிம்பாலிக் த யோகா ஸ்கூல்ஸ் பிலீவ் இன் தட் இட்ஸ் அ சிம்பாலிக் திங் நாட் நாட் ரியல் தட்ஸ் வை வி ஆல்வேஸ் சே நவத்வாரே புரே தேஹி கதோபனிஷத் சேஸ் நவத்வாரே புரே தேஹி it doesn't talk about the 10th it doesn't talk about the 10th hole rashagiran yeah
yes sir
angalam povadinga po innu confusion aagum erkanave too much of confusion huh?
yes,
there is no 10th gate there are only
9 gates
there are only 9 gates seriya with this we conclude for today and we continue 14 next session.